China is at a turning point, propelled to be the world's second largest economy by 30 years of exponential GDP growth. China now faces a slowdown and significant macroeconomic questions. To ensure sustainable growth, China is focused on increasing domestic consumption and rebalancing its economy. To avoid the middle-income country trap at which GDP growth plateaus, China will increasingly depend on its ability to produce globally competitive companies to move away from low-cost manufacturing towards output driven by innovation. This means having companies that can learn, operate, and compete in developed markets, as well as acquire internationally recognized brands, bring them back to China, and develop the domestic market. This will have profound implications worldwide. China's new economic policy includes internationalizing its currency, the RMB. This is the vehicle for greater capital account liberalization and increasing outbound investment. The proportion of China's worldwide trade settled in RMB is rising rapidly, and the range of RMB financial products is steadily increasing. Hong Kong remains the current world center for RMB product development, but the picture is increasingly global. The offshore RMB bond market is also flourishing. Of the almost $30 billion raised since 2011, more than one quarter was by non-Chinese entities. But the operational advance which could truly globalize the RMB is the creation of a new China international payment system, which will allow international banks to have a direct relationship with China's central bank. Simultaneously, China recognizes the need to increase outbound investment and attract targeted foreign investment into China. China has invested over $327 billion in outbound M&A since 2005 and significantly grown its share of global M&A activity. In this period, China grew its presence in every region. China is increasingly targeting a broader range of sectors. Inbound investment to China from the rest of the world remains a core strategic tool in China's growth. But China is now adopting a more targeted approach, prioritizing certain sectors and regions. It's not a question of whether to engage with China, but how and when.